Good morning, students. Today we'll be learning about the characteristics of a wave. A wave can be described by four characteristics: wavelength, amplitude, time period, and frequency. What is wavelength? Before we discuss about it, let us look at the diagram given. A waveform is shown in the figure. A wave is characterized by one positive displacement and one negative displacement about the mean position. So one up and one down, that is a complete wave. Now the minimum distance in which a sound wave repeats itself is called its wavelength. That is, it is the length of one complete wave, that means one up and one down. It is denoted by the Greek letter lambda. We know that a sound wave, the combined length of a compression and an adjacent rarefaction, it is known as wavelength, because sound wave is a longitudinal wave, it is a material wave which is characterized by compression and rarefaction. So one compression and the adjacent rarefaction makes one wavelength. Also, the distance between the centers of two consecutive compression or two consecutive rarefaction is also known as wavelength, as it is shown in the figure. The distance between the centers of a compression and the adjacent rarefaction is equal to half of its wavelength, that is lambda by 2. SI unit for measuring wavelength is meter, because it is nothing but a length. Now, what is amplitude? This word we have learned when we have done the oscillatory motion of a pendulum. A pendulum has a mean position or an equilibrium position about which the pendulum oscillates to and fro. So the maximum displacement of the bob from its mean position was called amplitude. How that motion is related to this wave? Here also, the horizontal line that is depicting the mean position or equilibrium position. The displacement of the pendulum bob on two sides, right hand side and left hand side of the mean position, is shown by the upward displacement and downward displacement of the waveform. So when a wave passes through a medium, the particles of the medium get displaced temporarily from their original undisturbed positions. The maximum displacement of the particle of the medium from the original undisturbed position, that means from the horizontal line, when a wave passes through the medium, is known as amplitude. Here the amplitude is shown by the double-sided arrow in the diagram. It is denoted by the letter small a, and SI unit of measurement of amplitude is also meter. Note that wavelength and amplitude both have same SI unit, that is meter, because both are depicting lengths. Now we'll be discussing about time period. The time required to produce one complete wave or one cycle is called time period of the wave. Now, one complete wave is produced by one full vibration of the vibrating body. So we can say that the time taken to complete one vibration is known as time period. It is denoted by the letter capital T, not small t. The unit of measurement of time period is second. So we can say that A wave takes capital T second to travel a distance of lambda that is equal to its wavelength. Similarly, the fourth characteristic is frequency, the number of complete waves or cycles produced in 1 second is known as frequency of the wave. Since one complete wave is produced by one full vibration of the vibrating body, so we can say that the number of vibrations per second is called frequency. For example, if 10 complete waves or vibrations are produced in 1 second, then the frequency of wave will be 10 hertz or 10 circles per second. In the figure, two waves are shown. The first one is completing more number of oscillations in shorter time interval than the second one. So it is having high frequency. SI unit of frequency is hertz, or we can write it as Hz. A vibrating body emitting one wave per second is said to have a frequency of 1 hertz. That is, 1 hertz is equal to 1 vibration per second. Sometimes a bigger unit of frequency is known as kilohertz. Kilo means 1000, so 1 kilohertz is equal to 1000 hertz. The frequency of wave is denoted by the letter small f. What is the relation between time period and frequency of a wave? As we have already discussed, the time required to produce one complete wave is called time period of the wave. Suppose the time period of a wave is capital T seconds. That means we can say that in T seconds, the number of waves produced is 1. If we use unitary method, we can say in 1 second, the number of wave produced will be less. So we are dividing 1 by T. Capital T. But the number of waves produced in 1 second is also known as frequency by its definition. So we can say frequency is equal to 1 by time period. That means f is equal to 1 by T, where small f is the frequency of the wave and capital T is the time period of the wave. So we can say that frequency and time period are reciprocal to each other. Now let us do one numerical. A simple pendulum makes 20 oscillations in 40 seconds. What is the time period and frequency of oscillation? Time period is equal to time by number of oscillations, that is equal to 40 by 20, that is equal to 2 seconds. Now, frequency is equal to number of oscillations by time. So, it will be 20 by 40, that is 0.5 hertz. We can also find out frequency by simply calculating the reciprocal of 2, because f is equal to 1 by t. So, if we write 1 by 2, that will also give us 0.5 hertz. What do you mean by audible sound? Audible means which we can listen to. The sound which we can hear clearly is known as audible sound. It has a range of frequencies from 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. What does it mean? That means when we know that sound is produced by vibration. When the vibrating source oscillates at a rate of 20 times per second to 20,000 times per second, or their frequencies are between 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz, then the sound produced are perceived by our human brain. We are calling it audible sound. Then what are infrasonic sound and ultrasonic sound? Sounds which have frequency lower than 20 hertz are called infrasonic sound. For example, when we wave our hands or the oscillation of a pendulum, it is much less than 20 hertz. That means in 1 second, less than 20 oscillations are completed. So we cannot listen to these sounds. Similarly, sound which have frequency greater than 20,000 hertz are called ultrasonic sound. That is not also audible to us. Animals like dog, bat, monkey, deer, etc. can hear to ultrasonic sound. Animals like whale, elephant, hippopotamus, giraffe, etc. can hear ultrasonic sound. Now we'll be discussing about applications of ultrasound. Ultrasounds are high frequency waves which have frequency more than 20,000 hertz, which can travel in definite paths even in the presence of many obstacles. We use this property of ultrasound in different types of medical and industrial applications. Let us see how it is applied in medical science. Ultrasonic waves are used to capture the images of heart and its features and problems associated with heart. This is known as echocardiography. Ultrasonic scans or ultrasonography are very commonly used to get images of our internal body organs like liver, kidney, uterus, etc. It is used for diagnostic purposes. Ultrasound waves are made to travel through the body and through the organs under consideration. They get reflected and they are converted into electrical signal which can be monitored on a screen. Ultrasonography is used to observe the growth of fetus inside the uterus and to locate any kind of abnormalities in the fetus. It is also used in microsurgery to break kidney stones into fine grains. Ultrasonic sound has industrial applications also. Ultrasound is used to clean machinery parts located in places where we cannot access easily. Electronic components, internal parts, spiral parts, etc. where we cannot reach, ultrasonic wave can reach and it can clean those parts. The objects are placed in a cleaning solution and waves are passed through it. Because of the high frequency wave, the dust particle just fall out. It is also used, this is very important application, to detect flaws or cracks in machinery parts for making bridges, buildings, etc. So it is very important to ensure that there is no flaw or crack in the metals. Ultrasound waves are passed at one end and monitored using detectors. If there are any flaws or cracks, then the ultrasound waves are reflected back, indicating the presence of a defect. It is also used to calculate the depth of sea by using sonar. What is the full form of sonar? S-O-N-A-R. It means sound navigation and ranging. Sonar is a device that uses ultrasonic waves to measure distances which are practically impossible to measure. Depth of ocean, distance and direction of underwater objects. A diagram is given there. Sonar has a transmitter and a detector. Transmitter is shown with a red box in the diagram and detector with a yellow box. Transmitter produces ultrasonic waves which travel through the water and hit the bottom of the ocean or seabed and return back. And detector is receiving that reflected signal. The time taken for the ultrasound to return, that is small t, and the speed of ultrasound sound in water V is known. Time is noted by a timekeeper. So we have distance d is equal to v into t by 2. Why it is divided by 2? Normal equation is distance is equal to speed into time. But here why it is divided by 2? Because the wave travels twice the distance, once while moving from transmitter to the seabed, second time from seabed to the detector. So we are dividing the total distance by 2. Let us do some numericals based on sonar or reflection of sound. A sonar device is attached to a ship which sends ultrasonic waves in the sea. These waves are reflected from the bottom of the sea. If the ultrasonic wave takes 4 seconds to travel from the ship to the bottom of the sea and back to the ship in the form of an echo, what is the depth of the sea? Speed of sound in water is 1500 meter per second. Let the depth of seabed be d. The time taken by the ultrasonic sound waves to travel from ship to seabed and back to the ship is 4 seconds. So during an interval of 4 seconds, the ultrasonic wave travels this distance twice, once while traveling from ship to seabed and once while returning from seabed to ship. Total distance traveled is equal to d plus d2d. As we know that speed of ultrasonic wave is equal to distance by time, so here we are substituting the value of speed of ultrasound. 1500 is equal to 2d by 4. Remember, instead of writing d for distance, we are writing 2d because the distance is traveled twice. If you calculate and simplify, we'll be getting d is equal to 1500 into 4 by 2 after cross multiplication, and d is 3000 meter. What is an echo? If we stand in corner of a big empty hall or in front of a hill and shout the word hello, we will hear the word hello coming from the empty hall or from the hill in the form of an echo a little while later. This is our common experience. This happens because the sound is reflected from the walls of the hall or from the hill. The repetition of sound caused by the reflection of sound waves is called an echo. It is basically the reflected sound. Here we must mention that like light waves, sound waves also undergo the phenomenon of reflection, and it follows the same laws of reflection. An echo is heard when sound is reflected from a hard surface such as tall brick wall or a cliff. A soft surface tends to absorb sound, so no sound is reflected back or no echo is produced. Here we must mention that speed of sound in air at 20 degrees Celsius is 344 meter per second. Now, what should be the minimum distance of the rigid reflector to hear an echo? Let the distance of the rigid reflector be d. Human ear can hear two sounds separately only if there is a time interval of 1 by 10th of a second or more between the two sounds. Otherwise, our brain fails to recognize them as two different sounds. So during an interval of 1 by 10 seconds, the sound wave should travel the distance between the source and the reflector twice, once from source to rigid wall, second time from rigid wall to the source. So total distance traveled, as we did in the previous sum, d plus d is equal to twice d. Speed of ultrasonic wave is equal to, speed of sound is equal to distance by time. So we can substitute the value of speed of sound. 344 is equal to 2d divided by 1 by 10. So if you simplify that, d will be is equal to 344 into 1 by 10 by 2, or d is equal to 17.2 meter. So we can conclude that the minimum distance from a sound reflecting source to hear an echo is 17.2 meter. Now, what are the characteristics of sound? A sound has three characteristics: loudness, pitch, and quality or timbre. What is loudness? The loudness of sound is a measure of sound energy reaching our ear per second. Loudness of sound depends on the amplitude of the sound waves. Greater the amplitude of sound waves, louder will be the sound. Loudness of sound is measured by the unit decibel or dB. Now, here in the diagram, two waves are shown. The question is, out of the two given sound waves, which one is louder? Obviously, the second sound wave is louder because it has more amplitude. So, more amplitude means more displacement from its mean position. So, loudness will be more. Now, what is pitch? Pitch is that characteristic of sound by which we can distinguish between different sound waves of same loudness or same amplitude, we can say, but different in their frequencies. Pitch of sound depends on frequency of vibration. More is the frequency of sound, more will be the pitch or shrillness. Now, in the diagram, first diagram, two sound waves are given. We have to identify which one has more shrillness or more pitch. That means which one is more sharp, sharper sound. As pitch depends on frequency, in the second figure, we can see it has more frequency. So, in 1 second, more number of vibrations are completed. So, the second figure has more pitch or more shrillness. The third characteristic of sound is timbre. Look at the spelling T-I-M-B-R-E, or quality. Quality is that characteristic of sound which distinguishes one sound from other sound having same loudness and pitch. That means having same amplitude and same frequency, but which are originated from different instruments or different sources. The three characteristics of sound are shown in the second diagram, that how they are different. The first one, which is given in violet color, that is loudness, which is differing, the two waves are differing in their amplitude. The second one, that is pitch, the two sound waves are differing in their frequency. The third one, that is quality or timbre, that is differing in their wave nature, waveform. In the third figure also, different waveforms are given, which are arising from tuning fork, vibration of tuning fork, vibration of flute, vibration of larynx of human being, and from violin. So all waveforms are different. These diagrams will help you to understand the three characteristics of sound graphically. Let us discuss few answers. First question, the sound in human is produced by which organ? The correct option is C, larynx. Question number two, frequency of sound is lowest for man, woman, young boy and young girl. This one is a little bit tricky. Here we have to identify out of these four, which one has the shrillest
voice? The answer is young girl. And the so young girl has the highest pitch of her voice. And who has the lowest pitch? Man has the lowest pitch. So as we know that pitch of sound depends on frequency, if the pitch is lowest, then the frequency will also be the lowest for a man. Question number 3, in which medium sound travels the fastest? The answer is solid. Sound travels the fastest through solids, and that is why if we just put our ear on a railway track, we can listen to the sound of an approaching train faster through rail than in air. Next question, an object vibrated with a frequency of 15 hertz. Which of the following is true? It produces sound which we can hear. It does not produce sound. It produces sound which we cannot hear, and produces sound we can hear if we strain our ears. The answer is, it produces sound which we cannot hear. Why? Because audible range of frequency is from 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. And here the frequency of vibration is 15, which is less than 20 hertz. So we cannot hear this sound. Next one is a direct question. Unit of frequency, we all know it is hertz. B is the correct option. Inverse of frequency is called time period. D is the correct option, because reciprocal to frequency is time period. F is equal to 1 by T. Next question. Time taken for 10 oscillations of a body in 20 seconds. Then time period of the body is, how to calculate that? Time period means time taken to complete one oscillation. So if 10 oscillation takes 20 seconds, by unitary method we are getting one oscillation will take 20 by 10, that means 2 seconds. B is the correct option. Next one, the hearing range of human ear is 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. That is the audible range we have already discussed. 13th one, large amplitude of vibration will produce what kind of sound? Loud sound, because loudness is proportional to amplitude. More amplitude means more loudness. 14th one, the pitch of sound depends on frequency. This is also discussed. 17th question, shrill sound is of high frequency, always higher frequency, because shrillness or pitch of sound depends on frequency. 18th, flat sound is of lower pitch. Flat means which has lower shrillness, so it is of lower pitch or lower frequency. 19th one, frequency of a body is 10 hertz, then it is in the range of infrasonic sound. The sound which has frequency less than 20 hertz, we are calling it infrasonic. Unit of loudness is, it is not mentioned here. The unit of loudness is decibel. Here the options are hertz, meter, second. So none of this will be the answer. The correct answer is decibel. Number 21. The speed of sound in solid, liquid and gas can be correctly compared as. So speed of sound is the fastest in solid, and then in liquid, then in gas. So here it is shown in descending order. So which one will be the correct option? The first one. It is highest in solid, then in liquid, then in gas. 22nd question, a person pressing his ear on the railway track can hear an approaching train. This is possible due to vibration of railway tracks, vibration of air, more speed of sound in solid medium, and hearing ability of the man. C is the correct option because sound travels faster in solid than in air. So the one who is pressing his ear on the railway track, sound is reaching to him faster than air. 26th question, the velocity of sound in vacuum is, it will be approximately 332 meter per second. Flash of thunder are produced simultaneously. Flash and thunder are produced simultaneously, but thunder is heard few seconds after the flash is seen. This is because speed of sound is greater than speed of light. Is it true? Not at all, because speed of sound is only 332 meter per second and speed of light is much greater than that. That is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. The second option is speed of sound is equal to speed of light. That is not also true. The third option is speed of light is much greater than the speed of sound. That is why, as because light travels with a speed of 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, it reaches faster to our eyes than the sound of the thunder, because sound travels only 332 meter in 1 second. Next question. An object oscillates 50 times in 1 second. What should be its frequency? So it is oscillating 50 times in 1 second. What is the definition of frequency? The number of complete oscillations in 1 second. That is frequency. So the correct option is D, that is 50 hertz. Last question. The time period of simple pendulum is 0.2 seconds. What is the frequency of oscillation? Now we have to know here, what is the relationship between time period and frequency? Time period is just the reciprocal of the frequency of oscillation. So if time period is 0.2 seconds, frequency will be 1 by t, that means 1 by 0.2. If you calculate, you are getting 5 hertz. So B is the correct option. Hope all of you understood the concepts taught. If you face any difficulty, we can clarify your doubt in Microsoft Teams class. Thank you, children.